Good evening from Raleigh, North Carolina, on this Monday, January the 15th, 2018, at approximately 7:45 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And remember to make all decisions based on official forecast products released by the National Weather Service and official entities, and that this video only reflects some very light analysis and my opinions. And today is Martin Luther King Jr. Day, and it seems strangely enough that this is always kind of a key time in North Carolina's winter where we get some kind of winter precipitation, a pretty hot time for cold weather, if you will. But once again, we're dealing with a chance for some wintry weather, and it's looking more likely that we will have at least a little burst of snow on Wednesday morning, late Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. That would be late tomorrow night and then into the morning of January 17th for number-oriented listeners. But it is looking likely that we are going to see some snow. Not a very big event, but it could be an impactful event due to the cold temperatures staying in place and could cause some problems on the road. So let's jump right in with those temperatures. And this is for Raleigh-Durham International Airport. And these are the ensemble pictures. Again, if you've watched any of my videos recently, these are showing the probabilities of temperatures. The smaller these little box and whisker plots, the more certain that temperature is. And then the bigger they get, the more uncertain. And of course, there's more uncertainty, about a week or so out. But for the forecast for tomorrow, pretty certain that we're going to, top out in the upper 40s. And that's good news for soil temperatures, because that could mean that the ground warms just a tad bit to keep any accumulating snow from sticking to the roads. But I still think it's going to be cold enough that there will be some problems, that if anything does fall, or at this point we're confident it will fall, that how much falls and how quickly it falls is going to be key in determining if we have any road impacts, which is obviously one of the major, major impacts of winter storms. So hopefully that this will get warm enough tomorrow to have kind of a pleasant day, and it'll warm the soil up to where it'll be pretty to watch, but it won't have many impacts in the transportation world. But we'll see about that. I think it's still going to be kind of a problem, and I'll tell you why in a couple of slides. But overall here, you see that we're going to endure through our cold snap. 49 is not that bad, so I'll kind of cut that off here, and then we might have a warmer weekend getting into the 60s by January 21st, 22nd through Sunday and Monday. And next week looks normal. Our normal average high temperature this year is 51 degrees. So we are slowly climbing toward that, but we have to get through this cold snap and this little winter event on Tuesday night into Wednesday, I should say, before we warm up. And just to show you the same kind of ensembles for Greensboro, pretty much the same thing, but just wanted to show you the difference here for Greensboro. Upper 40s, and then Wednesday is going to be cold, with our high probably only topping out, not even getting above freezing, and then warming up. And the 16 has now popped up, which was different than yesterday, which might be because it's the model's kind of anticipating there being snow cover on the ground, which would lower the temperatures even more overnight. So that's certainly a signal that it's still going to be very cold, and we'll finally warm up more comfortably to more of normal-like conditions on this weekend. And so that kind of tells the story of our air temperature. So let's go over to our soil temperatures now. And I showed this map last night, and not much has changed because the soil, is very hard to warm up very quickly in a day. But that 40, how warm it gets tomorrow is going to be very key in determining how warm it gets here, because this 33 and 34, if those temperatures kind of stay where they are and don't really change, that could spell some big issues for road problems here. That 40 is kind of encouraging for maybe parts of the RTP, a Research Triangle Park, or the Triangle area. But these numbers are still low enough that if anything, when anything does fall, and if it falls fast enough, it could cause a lot of problems on the roads. And I'll kind of rehash that to summarize the end of this video. But it looks like the weather itself is not going to be impactful. The big impacts from this are going to be on the roads if it falls quick enough, and depending on what, how heavy it does fall down, because temperatures are going to be right around freezing, probably just a couple degrees below, so it's going to be freezing the entire time. All precipitation should fall as snow with maybe a little bit of sleet mix. It's not going to be an ice storm or anything like that, but the weather itself, barring the besides the visibility issues if you're driving in the snow for morning commute, besides that, the main impact from this is just going to be the covered roadways. And I've already seen a couple of brine trucks out today here in Raleigh, so I know that they're prepping for it, and this is a very crucial part of, Tobacco Road, you may have heard, or Interstate 40 right here, which looks to kind of get the brunt of this and may get 1 to 2 inches of snow, which could cause some travel issues, so we have to look out for that. But moving on now, kind of to graphically show you where the temperatures are expected to go, this will cooperate with me, here we go. So if you look down here, here's your timestamp, and you can look, this is 1 a.m. Wednesday, so, about 24, 30 hours from now or something like that. And if we're going every time I advance here, you see the image change. That's an hour ahead, and you can see what's going to be causing this is a cold front, and there's going to be kind of a developing low out here, and it's going to cause not even it's a different kind of setup for every winter storm, and I'm getting confused with the winter storms, but just remember that there's a cold front, and there's the leading edge of this cold front is going to be where the precipitation is going to be at its most intense. If we continue going forward in time here, this is 5 a.m. You have 7 a.m., 9 a.m. And I'll go and stop at lunchtime here. And you can see that by lunchtime, the 12 p.m. noon on Wednesday, most of the areas are in the upper 20s, maybe the freezing line kind of right around the transition between the Piedmont and the coastal plain. And that's going to mean that anything that's falling here is going to be snow and it's going to be sticking to the roads. So if I kind of flip over now, and this is a significant weather parameter, which is basically showing what the main kind of weather type is going to be. And we're starting at midnight once again. If we go forward here, you can see that, not really impressed, but then all of a sudden it's going to blossom up as it goes away from the mountains, and it's going to kind of form this large band of snow, the swath of snow along this cold front, and it's going to kind of build in and then slowly kind of trek its way eastward, southeastward, almost kind of a little southward component to that, but it's going to continue to work across the state and give, it's probably going to, give probably 1 to 2 inches of snow for most of central North Carolina, especially north central North Carolina. So anywhere in this area, I think it's going to be where you have your biggest impacts from this, because it looks like that snow is going to kind of develop and then kind of sit there for a minute or a couple hours, not a minute, and then move off to the east. So I think that anywhere within this area, the Triad, I think you're in a prime spot for this. Probably Durham, maybe up toward the North Carolina Virginia border. Danville, Roxborough is must have a horseshoe around their town hall or something, because they're very lucky whenever it comes to winter weather, often getting a lot of the highest totals in any kind of event, and it looks like this may be one of those events as well. So kind of going ahead here, this is look at the National Weather Service enhanced data display, and this is just kind of a projection, a kind of a blend of models that's showing you snowfall totals across the area. And here's North Carolina, you can see here. And it has, a point in the RDR report, 1.3 inches. Not mean to make this window come up, but over here in the Triad, 1.1 inches, and then kind of the heaviest, if I can even zoom in here to get a little more detail. There we go. You have, lighter around, inch here, an inch here, maybe, a half inch down in Charlotte, but it looks like the most impactful and the heaviest snow totals, the highest snow totals, which are still going to be pretty light, generally speaking, but for this storm, the relative, maximum is going to be up here at the North Carolina Virginia border, up into central Virginia. So it looks like North Carolina is still going to see snow, but it's not going to be a huge impactful event. So if that translates into impacts and kind of a impact of what we expect, it looks like the National Weather Service Raleigh just updated this map. But this is their best guess, this is their expected snowfall through 7 a.m. on Tuesday or Thursday, excuse me. So this is the whole range, the entire event. Maybe an inch in the Triad, maybe Greensboro kind of being in a sweet spot, getting two up into the triangle area, getting anywhere from 1 to 2, and then kind of slowly fading off as you go. I can go back to this and show, as if we go back here, if we go from 4 p.m. on, it's kind of breaks down pretty quickly and kind of fizzles out, and you have mixing issues down here at the coast where it may be too warm for any really snow to be observed. So I think anywhere east of I-95, while the last event was your event and you got most of the snow there, I think that's going to be the cutoff here for any kind of significant snowfall accumulation. I think that east of I-95, you're kind of out of luck for this one, unless you are north of maybe this, US 264 or US 64 corridor that kind of runs through here out to the Outer Banks right here. Anywhere up here is still in play, but it looks like the majority of it's going to be in right in the heart of North Carolina and northward. Looks like Raleigh kind of might be on that line, but as we saw in the last storm, there are certainly hot spots where areas can pick up, more than forecast, and areas that are going to get less than forecast. So take this with a grain of salt. But this is their expected snowfall forecast. And I just wanted to jump over to the National Weather Service Lynchburg office, which covers these counties here, while the National Weather Service in Raleigh cutoff is right in Forsyth County and Guilford County here. I'll jump over to here just to show you another map, just to get, the full scope of North Carolina. Wilkesboro is probably going to be in this kind of dry slot area where the snow is going to kind of fizzle out and then reform to the east. So it looks like this is not the not the storm for the foothills of the mountains and down through Wilkesboro, down through Hickory and areas like that, but Yadkinville, maybe about an inch, but it looks like the triad's going to be where kind of it ramps up and begins to actually become a big swath of snow. So these counties, and I think Roxboro and Oxford and Henderson over in this area, Durham down here along the Interstate 40 corridor, I think it's going to be where the biggest impacts are felt from this storm. So overall, I'm going to show you my favorite side here. If you've watched any of my videos, you've seen this quite a few times now, but I think it's a very good app, and I think it's a very good addition to your weather app arsenal. And I think that it could come into play on Wednesday. And kind of to go through here, it offers all of these things that are listed here. If you just go to the iOS, or the if you have an iPhone, Apple operating system, you can just go to the App Store and download ReadyNC. Just Google it. Not Google, excuse me. Search it as one word, just Ready NC. It doesn't have to be capitalized or anything. And it will come up. It's a free app and it covers all of these things, current weather conditions, and it has a feed straight from the North Carolina Emergency Management and other National Weather Service entities that give them direct weather information. And I think the biggest help this could be is the real-time traffic conditions, especially on Wednesday morning, because it looks like this is going to ramp up right when the commute and the rush hour going to work in the morning on Wednesday is going to be happening, which is pretty concerning, especially being in that kind of transition zone between Greensboro, Burlington, Chapel Hill, Durham, Raleigh. Raleigh, RTP, if you live anywhere around the Raleigh area, you know that that traffic is daily. It's always there. It's like an entity that it's always there every morning. So I'm kind of concerned about that, especially with the snow moving in. Number one, that reduces the visibility when you're driving, so you have to reduce your speed. But also with any accumulating snow on the roadways, that's certainly going to be an issue, and it's going to be the big story. That's going to it's either if it's just cold enough and the soil temperatures don't warm up that much tomorrow, it could be a lot bigger of an issue, where you've heard of the stories and you've probably lived through the stories where an inch of snow shuts down a majority of the state, and that could be it's possible with this system if the roads are cold enough and it comes down quick enough. And we have a little bit of an overperforming storm on our hands where maybe you're getting 2 to 3 inches instead of 1 to 2, or maybe areas that were supposed to not get as much snow that maybe weren't properly brined, maybe they get 1 or 2 inches of snow, and then all of a sudden you have a big problem. So that's something we have to look out for, but it looks like it's going to be confined to central and north central North Carolina. Power outages should not be an issue because this should be a pretty quick moving system. There is no ice involved. There could be some sleet and snow mix or some rain snow mix, but it looks like the majority of this will just be snowfall. So I don't really see power outages as being a thing. Evacuations, I don't think it's going to be that serious, but the main thing here is the traffic conditions are very useful on this app, where you can see road conditions that will give you live updates, or rather a recent list, I guess is what I'm trying to say, of any road conditions and closings near you, so you can know that if you must travel, which is highly advised against. I mean, myself, I have to go to North Carolina State University's campus, so I will be in Raleigh during all of this because I do not think there's going to be any kind of adverse weather policy in effect. So I will be in this with everyone else who commutes. So we'll see how that pans out. But it looks like you can just expect a swath of snow. And if I go back here, rewind here to about 12 a.m., I'll play this one more time to summarize and end the video. It looks like we'll have this, band of snow that's kind of going to develop. Probably fill in and completely be on a radar maybe by 8 or 9 a.m. And then by mid-morning, we're looking at a swath of snow across central North Carolina, could tail all the way down into the Midlands and through Columbia, down through Augusta, Georgia, continue to work off its way to the east and continue to march on and quickly fizzle out as it kind of approaches that I-95 corridor and quickly kind of breaks down and becomes much of a non-issue after that. But it looks like the main impact hours are going to be anywhere from 5 a.m. to 5 p.m. That 12-hour window looks like it's going to be the worst of the weather. So with that being said, I'll put another forecast video out tomorrow with some hopefully refined details. The models are really beginning to come into agreement, and that was mentioned in the National Weather Service Raleigh's forecast discussion. They're saying the confidence is pretty high in this happening now. The only confidence is snowfall totals. It looks like it's going to be a pretty quick storm, but there is some dynamics in there that could result in a couple areas getting maybe a little bit more, a little bit less snow. So that's going to be refined over the next few hours and into tomorrow. So I'll have that video out tomorrow. If you have any questions, feel free to message me on Facebook, on YouTube, or tweet me at @AndrewsWXCenter. And Yeah, I'm easy to get a hold of, and if you have any questions, just contact me. Otherwise, stay safe, stay warm, and I'll see you on the next video. Thanks.